Hey guys, so when you think of sneaker collection videos, you probably expect to see a lot of Nike shoes, a lot of Adidas shoes, a lot of Jordans, a lot of hype. But for today's episode, I will share with you some of my most underrated and most used sneakers in my collection. This is my Under Armour sneaker collection. Let's go! So when it comes to Under Armour sneakers, I pretty much cut them up into three categories. You have your running, super comfortable sneakers. You have your training shoes if you're into CrossFit or training in the gym. And then you have your Japorm sneakers. You know, they're loud colors, they're fun, they're crazy. So what I'll do today is I'll share with you some of my favorite sneakers across those three categories. Excited? Tara! So let's start with this. This is my first or one of my first ever Under Armour Hover sneaker. So those who don't know, Hover is like their Boost. So it is like a super soft, responsive midsole. So yan yon. You see the lines inside? So that's like a mesh, keeping the Hover technology or the Hover circles together. And it's encased in this foam midsole. Super comfortable, super nice on feet. So this is the blue one, one of the very first. It's called the Hover Phantom. This red one is called the Hover Sonic. So this is the first generation Hover Sonic. So this one is like a more low-cut version, while this one is medyo mid-cut ang dating niya. Now eventually, they upgraded the model to this. So this is like the Under Armour Hover Run or Hover Phantom Run. And as you guys can see, it has that really kick-ass mid-cage. Look at that, super nice. And then it has a higher pull tab here at the back. It has your heel tip with the Under Armour logo. And again, you have the Hover technology encased in this foam midsole. This one was like easily far more comfortable and far more easier to wear compared to the first Under Armour Hover Phantom. I prefer this one a lot. And then quite recently, I think it was just a couple of weeks back, they launched this. This is the new Under Armour Hover Phantom 3 or 2. Basta yung pinakabago. And this one kicks the ass of a lot of the more well-known shoes today. The cushioning, the feel, the stability. This is just an all-around friggin' amazing shoe. And I cannot praise this sneaker enough. I absolutely am loving this. And as you guys can see from the bottom, I have been wearing the heck out of this white shoe. Easily one of my favorite white sneakers to date. The new Under Armour Hover 3 or 2. Basta yung pinakabagong Hover Phantom. Now let's move on over to the sneakers of Under Armour that are good for like going out. So there's still Hover Tech. So this is the laceless Under Armour Hover Phantom. So this one is like a rainbow colored thing going on. I think this is part of their Pride line. And then we have this. I think this was like the Chinese New Year. So it is bright red. It has that pop of gold with the heel clip. And then you have speckles of gold dust all over the shoe. So if you want something red, something loud, something crazy, either of these two Hover Phantom laceless should work. If you want something really subtle, this one is like a triple white version of those. Super clean, super fresh, super dope. So this one, super nice. And then we also have this. This is like their Under Armour Hover Phantom Sashiko. So Sashiko, to those who don't know, I think it's like some sort of stitching that's used with traditional kimonos. So this one is blue, brown, white, Hover mid-tech. And then we get to the training shoe. So when it comes to training, I have Project Rock sneakers. This one is like their Hover Apex. And this one is, I think, Tri-Base or something. So this is the most affordable one. So sells for around 5,000. Super stable, but not as comfy in my opinion. But again, it's a training shoe. So it's meant to be flat. It's meant to keep your feet as close to the ground as possible. So don't expect sneakers like this to be super soft, right? This one though, this is a kick-ass workout shoe. This is the Apex or Hover Apex. I've been working out in this in the last few days. And man, this is super stable. If you do sudden lateral movement side to side, you won't twist your ankle. Yun yung napansin ko sa kanya. Because I don't know if it's made or weighted in a certain way, pero sobrang panalo in terms of stability. Super love this shoe for our home workout. So one of my favorite training shoes to date. And I also love the color blocking, the way the purple-pink thing contrasts with the black. Boom. And then, of course, we have the Project Rock sneakers. I'm a huge fan of Dwayne The Rock Johnson. I couldn't find the first-gen Project Rocks or the first-gen Rock collaboration sneakers. This is the second one, though. So this one is more of a high cut. You have the Brahma Bull logo at the back. This one is in white. This one is in black and yellow. So again, high cut. Nothing too fancy with the midsole. Nothing too cool about the technology used here. I used these two sneakers a lot last year. And then they came out with this. So this is the Project Rock sneaker. So really nice shoe again. Super comfy. They used Hover for this one. So this one is not as soft though as the running shoe. So they made it more stable, a little bit stiffer. So it can give you that close to the ground feel. I have it in black. We also have it in gray. So this one is in gray. We have that cute Brahma Bull logo in some sort of like salmon pink color. Brahma Bull logo here again on the heel clip. And again, Hover technology. Really nice shoe. And this one, man, this one is the latest Project Rock training shoes. And it is in this white and black color. Again, Project Rock Brahma Bull logo there at the heel clip. They're also Under Armour at the back. It says blood, sweat, respect. This one is like the superior evolution of all three. I mean, the problem with this is that it's so hard to put on. As in, effort siyang isuot because there's no pull tab. This one, you can easily slide your feet in because of this pull tab. And the back of your ankle is even supported better because of this padded foam. And the midsole on this one is also so much nicer. If this one was really more on the stiff part and not as soft, this one can actually also work some sort of like everyday shoe. So this one, you get more mileage out of it, in my opinion. So this is easily one of my favorite sneakers so far for the year. But again, please take that with a grain of salt, as I am a huge, Under Armour, Project Rock, Dwayne The Rock Johnson fan. And there you have it. Three different categories of Under Armour sneakers. I don't have Under Armour basketball shoes. I'm not a fan of the Stephen Curry's. I tried them. They're not just, you know, they're really not just wide feet friendly. So as much as I would want to wear them, the shoe just doesn't fit. So regardless if I go like a size up or a full size up, wala talaga. Now, if I were to pick like one super favorite, obvious naman yata, it's the Project Rock for like my go-to all-arounder, especially the latest version. I strongly recommend this one. Comes in different colors, so you guys might want to check that one out too, as well as the latest Under Armour Hover Phantom. Ang galing eh, because with every iteration, you see the improvements. You see that they actually listen to the complaints of the earlier models, and then they improve it. So ako, I'm super happy to see that. That as we see the newer models, there are actual, you know, changes and upgrades, and I look forward to the newer models. How about you guys? Which of the sneakers did I show that you kind of liked or loved the most? Let me know in the comment section. I would love to hear from you. And also, if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, we have 3 ongoing giveaways. We're giving away a Realme 7 Pro smartphone. We're giving away Off-White face masks, legit from Off-White Manila. And we're giving away a Travis Scott Astroworld towel, courtesy of Cup Garden. So the links to all the giveaways can be found in the description box. And please try to join ASAP because the draw for some of them will already happen on October 15. So that's just a few days from now. So make sure that you guys, well, are part of the draw. And with that said, that actually wraps up my vlog for today. Just wanted to show you this quick setup, primarily because actually the great folks over at Athletes Pro Philippines, or they're the distributor of Under Armour, asked me to take a shot of me with my shoes that they would send out in their email newsletter. So that's why I had to take out all the shoes and might as well do a vlog on it para isang labasan na lang, eh, no? And lastly, if you guys want to buy any of the sneakers here, I'll link down below to where you can buy them on Lazada. So you can find it on the description box, especially the ones that I recommend, okay? And with that said, I hope you guys enjoyed. As usual, this is Carlos signing out. Peace. God bless. What's up? Boom.